What up, YouTube? Back at you with a new video. I know it's been a long time since I made a video. Shit, life, man. You know, sometimes life hold you and have you. You got to deal with your life. So that's what I had to do. Deal with life, my life itself. So yeah, man. Back at y'all with a new video. And you would think it'd be an update on the Monte Carlo. I think we'd be in part five, but it's not an update on the Monte Carlo, man. I bought a new vehicle, man. Actually, I bought two new vehicles. So I bought one, didn't like it so much, so I went out and bought another. So I'm gonna sell this one, but I'm gonna show you the one that I bought first, and then show you what we're gonna get. So yeah, man, OBS Chevy. This is a 94 GMC Sierra I purchased. Need some work though, you know, it was rough, but I really like the OBS Chevys, but I really wanted the side step, so I got it for a stupid, crazy cheap price, so I bought it. I bought it, but I'm actually selling it to a friend of mine. He wants it, so me and him gonna do that together. So I wanted something a little bit better than that, so that's kind of what I did. You know, the Impala is going to the paint shop finally. She's going to get painted, and maybe next week I'm going to drop off to the paint shop. I took all the dual panels off, as you can see. I don't have the keys, it's door locked. But all the dual panels off on the car, man. Got all the dual panels. I got with Mr. Impala. He's putting my new door panels in. I mean, he's shipping me my new door panels, so that's coming. That's in the works. And yeah, man, Big Mo got some stuff coming. So Impala going to the paint shop. The MC still coming. I got something sweet with the MC that I just got. You know, when you building a car, man, remember this. You're gonna lose a little money and you're gonna make some changes along the way. But you know, it's all about the journey of building a car. So yeah, man, I got the old Ford hooked up. I'm gonna tell y'all like I always tell y'all, man, I got the Ford hooked up. This thing was worth its weight in gold. It cost me about $6,000. It was worth every penny because I've used it so many times. I'm gonna tell you like I always tell you, follow Life with Big Monk, man. Follow the channel, man. Got a lot of interesting things coming up to the channel. Yeah, man, we're gonna be doing it. 84 is sitting in my garage. We ain't doing too much with it right now. Really, I can't afford to do too much with it because I'm always trying to do too much. A friend of mine told me, you're trying to do too much at once, and that's the problem with me. I try to do too much at once. So yeah, man, when I come back at you, I'll be getting on the road, going to drive up to BR to go pick this car up. So just, well, when I get back, you'll see what I'm talking about. What up, YouTube? I'm back and I'm on location, man, and I got a surprise for you. Like I told you, I was going to pick up something else, and I got it from my boy Kevin. Man, he letting his baby go after 21 years. So now she my baby, and guess what? I had to do it, man. You ready for this? Yes, man. OBS Chevy. You can see the stance on her. She is awesome. Yes, AC works. And I know the first thing y'all saying is, man, Mark, you keep buying vehicles. Hey, man, that's what I do. You know I'm from New Orleans. You know I'm from Louisiana. Go Tigers, baby. This is a bad mama jam. You see how she sounds? She sounds great. She looks great. And guess what? I got it for a great price. This is a bad truck. This is a bad truck, man. And yes, the AC does work and it's cold. This is awesome. Yeah, man. I made it happen. When I get it home, we'll do a more in-depth review of it, and I'll be back. What up, guys? I'm back. It's part day two of this video, but you know we're gonna put it all together. Finally home, back in front of my door. So I wanted to give y'all a more in-depth walk around of the 1500 I picked up. It's a 93. Chevy 1500 OBS Cheyenne pick up. This inside of it has a bench seat and it blows snowballs in here, man. It's really cool. Has RPM gauge. I mean, the AC is really surprisingly cold, right? Very shocked at that. Dash is jammed up right now, so I'm gonna have to fix that. Let me really lift it up for y'all to see. So the dash need to be replaced. Some of it, you know, you can get that for like $400 bucks. But man, all this running, The car sounds great, sounds amazing. Pop the hood as well. Original engine in here. You see that they have a little problem with the door handle, with the panel. So these minor stuff. Sounds great. Some old Flowmasters on here. Man, this truck, gotta think this truck is 28 years old. It sounds amazing. Does have a problem with the fiberglass right here. That was the only thing I saw, and the owner, previous owner, painted it himself. It looked like it though, to be honest. But man, I mean, for the price I got it for, I thought it was a great deal. Matter of fact, when I gave my offer before I seen it, he thought I was crazy. You know, when you're buying cars, sometimes you gotta do that. You know, you could get burned like that. Sometimes you just gotta do it. Let's see if I can run with it. Give me a second. Shit. All right, y'all, I'm back. Had to get the hood open. It was a little weird to me. But yeah, like I said, original motor. He did change the AC compressor, he told me. But yeah, man, I mean, real cool little OBS Chevy, really nice. It's funny, cause the initial one I purchased, and then I got into it, looking at them and everything, I was like, man, I really, really want one. The only thing I don't like about this truck that I have to complain about is the no power windows and locks. I hate that. So I might have to do a conversion or whatever, but, and yeah, obviously I don't care for the bench seat. I mean, it's not as, when this particular truck came out, it was a cheaper model. But aside from that, man, it's a really sound truck. I'm a LSU baby, you know I'm from Louisiana. So I'm gonna take y'all in a spin on it and see if we can get it to do what it do, you know? I don't want no problems with copyright. Let's turn that music off. You know how that go. So yeah, it has 212 miles. I don't know if this volume is gonna pick up on how the truck is sounding. I don't know if that's gonna pick up, but let me tell you, man, this is a great looking truck, great sounding truck, and I'm telling you, the amount I paid for it, I thought it was worth every penny. HOA president said I was speeding, so I gotta kind of watch my speed around here. But truck sounds amazing, man. It lights up blue at night. I mean, you know, truthfully, man. I mean, I feel like I got lucky with the purchase of the truck. I like the price, you know. And, you know, being a car guy. And just a person who loves old vehicles, you know. You gotta, all right, neighbors, you gotta be willing to make purchases. You know, you can't be scared. You can't get in the game if you're not playing by the rules, you know. You know, some people don't understand. If you're not in the car game, you never understand. You know, this is my fifth vehicle, right? And really nothing is complete. Something is almost close, and I got a surprise on my original car. But, you know, man, if I look at it like this, you only can move so fast when it comes down to building a vehicle. And if I see a deal and I want something, I'm going to buy it. That's how I operate. That's why I saved my money. And I made good financial decisions so far in my life. So, I mean, I look at these cars as an investment. You can always sell them. And if somebody told you you can't, that's a lie. You can always sell these vehicles, man. But, man, this car can damn near skid off. Squirt off, I say skeet off, but you know what I'm saying. You can damn near burn rubber from a standstill position. Let me see. put that into context. All right, man, I'm out, man. Thank y'all for subscribing. Shout out to all my new subscribers, the people who gonna be watching me from going forward, and all my old ones from holding it down with me, man. I appreciate it. I know I don't put out enough content. I'm working on getting better with that. But I still gotta make a living for my family, you know, and do what I have to do financially. Because if not, I won't live in this house no more. Because I do got a mortgage to pay, man. It ain't paid for. All right, man, I'm out.